Alexander the Great, a seminal figure within history. His personality, vivaciousness, and courage transcended all. His vast empire was a culmination of political, economic, and martial success. However, this does not reveal the true tale of Alexander's greatness, for political intrigue, social upheaval, and divine inspiration truly shaped his character and the indisputable power that he held. Our story focuses on his visit in 332 BC to the Siwa Oasis, in which Alexander's image changed forever. Picture this. Mountainous sand dunes, a dry, dusty air, and the only sight in miles is a refreshing oasis entombed in this harsh environment. This is the Siwa Oasis, home to the temple of Zeus Amun, the god of the sun and air, and a widely recognized and venerated figure throughout the Hellenic world. So what happened during Alexander's visit to the temple? Alexander reached the temple of Amun and spoke to the prophet, a channel by which the god Amun would communicate through. It was here that Alexander's divinity was born, and he was said to be the son of Zeus Amun. Undoubtedly, this would have enhanced his position as a ruler, but furthermore acted as a means by which to unify the manifold of cultures within his empire, in that they would all respect and devote themselves to a figure whom they believed was divine. Our three main sources come from Plutarch, Arrian, and Diodorus Siculus. Arrian describes the scene romantically when stating that two crows, flying in advance of the army, acted as guides to Alexander, signaling divine intervention. He also comments that Alexander made his inquiry of the god. Interestingly, Arrian also states that Alexander received the answer his heart desired, thereby raising the question as to how far this claim was fabricated, not only by Alexander, but indeed the prophet of the oracle. Conversely, Plutarch describes his journey through the desert, an ultimate realization that he had no mortal father, when asking about the killers of his supposed mortal father, Philip of Macedon. Diodorus's account is similar to that of Arrian, in that he questions how far this entire event was contrived by commenting that Alexander supposedly asked the prophet, "But tell me, if thou givest me the rule of the entire earth," therefore demonstrating that Alexander merely sought greater provenance for control over his empire. Regardless of the interpretation, Alexander left the Siwa Oasis as a supposed son of Zeus Amun. Alexander's self-perception as a deity is demonstrated in a manifold of ways, chief amongst them being coinage released after his death, which depict him wearing the horns of Zeus Amun, an obvious link to the god. Furthermore, during his lifetime there are numerous reports that Alexander adopted proskynesis, either the symbolic kissing of the hand or prostration on the ground. Historian Robert Morcott asserts that this behaviour was considered by the Greeks to be the province of deities, and a clear sign that Alexander sought to deify himself. And so our tale ends. Alexander travelled to the Siwa Oasis in order to reinforce his claims as a divine figure, which he employed to enhance his control over an increasingly multicultural and diverse empire.